A lot of people always ask, how much does it cost to get into go-kart racing? And you know, I always have a simple, smart-ass remark about how much do you want to spend? But in all reality, it's actually fairly cheap. When we got into the racing, we didn't know anything about it. We didn't know about the karts. We didn't know what to look for. So we decided that we were going to buy brand new karts, brand new motors, and start from there. We brought pretty much this exact same kart, just a newer model, as you see here, but with wheels and tires. Shipped to our door for about $5,000. That is a little expensive for most people, but you can find used carts out there very easily for between $2,500 and $3,500, ready to go, ready to roll. You'll have a used motor, you know, but you just gotta know what to look for. And over this journey, we'll sit down and talk to you guys about how or what you need to look for in a used cart to make sure that you're getting something that you can use for a while. But you also gotta remember that you're probably gonna wreck it. You're probably gonna make some damage on the cart, so it's not a bad idea to buy a used cart. If I was gonna do it over again, probably would have bought a used cart to start, and once I got a little better, would have bought a new frame or a new cart and gone that way. These are 206 carts. This is a specific 206 cart that CRG makes. They make shifter carts, tag carts, they're a little bit faster. Also, they make cadet carts. This is my daughter's cart. It's also a 206 cart, and they do make these in a four-stroke 206, or you can do a two-stroke motor also for these. They're a smaller cart, they run less tire, and the motors are more restricted, but pretty much it's the same thing if you're looking at just differences in size. And that's it, but otherwise in setup and everything like that, it's pretty much the same. So I know what you guys are all thinking. You get your brand new cart, now you gotta change things, you gotta upgrade things. That's really not so true. A lot of these things are specific to an actual make of a cart. So a CRG cart takes specific parts for the CRG, so there's really not much to change. The only couple things that I've changed specifically on this cart was I got a different seat, one that fit me a little better, and one that was more flexible. I like to run a more flexible seat. They make them at different hardnesses depending on your tuning that you need in the cart. The other thing that I changed was an axle. So you change different stiffnesses of axles to tune the cart. I like to use a super soft 50 millimeter axle. A lot of people like to use a smaller diameter axle or sometimes even a harder axle, and it can benefit you maybe in the wet. You get a harder axle and get more grip. Some carts work the total opposite. So it all depends on your driving style, the type of frame that you have. But for the most part, that's the only two things that I've changed in this cart. One more component that's really important when you're tuning your cart, out on the track, a lot of organizations actually require you to have some sort of data logger on your cart. We use the Micron 5. There are a couple different companies that you can get, but this is the one that we choose, and it's the most common in our area. Sometimes they check these for make sure that you have your max RPM right. They take your lap times. You can also download all the information into your computer and check your corner speeds and compare lap to lap. So they're a really important tuning tool. With our Micron, we chose not to use a lot of the settings. You can do those for like with the tag motor, where you can do water temps, you can do gear changes with the shifters, you can do head temperatures. With our 206, basically the only settings you can really do is head temperatures, your lap times, your RPMs. We choose just to do the RPMs and lap times. That is it. No real reason to do anything more than that with a 206. There's a lot more capability in that data logger that we choose not to use at the moment. All right, guys, now it's time to get in a cart and try this out. You got a couple different options still. You can start rental cart racing in a little bit slower, bigger, heavier cart, and then move yourself into maybe a used cart. Or if you have the money to buy a brand new cart and not have to worry about the problems that come with a used cart. Also, a lot of tracks, you can look into your local track, offer a rental program. So you can do a rental of an actual 206 cart or better. Most of the time you need to prove yourself in a 206 cart before they let you rent a bigger cart, a faster cart. And we, like at our local track at PGP and a lot of the local tracks around here, there's a few guys that do actual race rentals. So they'll come out, help you out, bring the cart out, and you can get started that way and make sure that you like it before you invest all the money into actually your own cart. But having your own cart has its advantages. You get to work on it at home. You get to set it up exactly the way you like it to your driving style and not what someone you might think is your driving style. All right, guys, that's it for this video. Please subscribe, keep in touch. Next time, we're gonna start going more into depth into different components of the cart, maybe how to set up your cart a little bit more. And stay tuned, watch out for more.